Schimpff's Confectionery has been here behind these doors for 125 years, not me personally. And it was my husband's great-grandfather that started the business in 1891.
Warren, what are we making here today?
Cinnamon Red Hots.
Cinnamon Red Hots, and just what exactly is boiling in the kettle?
Sugar.
Sugar.
Corn syrup.
Corn syrup.
Water.
Water.
And red coloring.
Red coloring. Wait a minute, guys. What's missing in these Cinnamon Red Hots?
Cinnamon.
A cinnamon is a sharp crowd. We're going to keep guys.
I've been coming here all my life to visit his family, of course, my family. I got interested in making candy, seeing the old things that were done here. My cousin and my aunt and uncle using the old equipment. I got interested as an older teenager.
We've only been doing demonstrations for about 20 years. Before that, the family always wished that they could demonstrate in front of people, but all the manufacturing was done in the back where it was not possible.
Taking that thermometer out of the kettle. Watch carefully now. There it goes. Oh, be very, very glad your little fingers aren't under there. I wonder if it's ready for the cinnamon oil. Oh, if it's ready for the cinnamon oil. Look at that. Nice little circle of cinnamon oil. Now, if you're a country music fan, you know Johnny Cash made Ring of Fire really popular. There are ships Ring of Fire right there. Cinnamon Fire. Watch now. This is the pretty part. Oh, look at that.
Family has always told the next generation what it was like when they were in charge, and so it was easily passed from one generation to the next. And of course, children of the owners worked in the store, so they were a part of the history as it went along.
How many people can actually smell the cinnamon? Oh, way down here. All right, hands down. I know I can smell it. Warren, do you smell the cinnamon? Poor Warren. He gets a double dose, doesn't he? The joys of working with cinnamon.
As far as the recipes that we use, great-grandfather and grandfather started a recipe book together, one from the beginning of the book and one from the end of the book. And there are simple hard candy recipes that we still use today.
Called the drop roll machine because it makes hard candy drops. Whether they're cinnamon drops, licorice drops, lemon drops, whatever. So more. I'm going to take this little mini scissors and chop off a little piece of that candy. There it goes. Now, Warren, don't put it through yet. We have to cross our fingers and hope it comes through squares. Cross fingers. Squares. What do you know? You cross your fingers just right. And look how the sugar helps me. Slides, glide the candy easily over the surface. Takes all the work right out of my job, doesn't it? Well, we do four flavors on the square dies. We do the cinnamon red hots that you're watching us make today. We do anise, we do clove, and then we do something called the Warhound cough drop. This machine that we're using today was hand-cranked. And Warren remembers the days of cranking brew. In the old days, candy makers had to have a new muscle to make candy.
My favorite candy to make is, of course, the cinnamon red hots. It's just fun to do. We love to do it for tours. It gives people an idea of something you can't see at a lot of other places. You find candy shops that'll make fudge or saltwater taffy and things like that, but very few places make hard candy like we do here.
Uh-oh. Warren, look at their faces. Nobody's been felt.
Start
all over again, right? You're wondering how we separate these little red hots. Actually, this has taken us 125 years of a lot of research to develop. Oh! Well, look at that. Warren, do another one. This crowd is easily amused. This is wonderful. Cinnamon. Red hot.
Flower's signature piece is the cinnamon red hot, which is not burn a hole in your tongue hot, it's just mildly spicy. And then the other hard candies that were traditional in the old days, clove and lemon and peppermint, old-fashioned hard candies, stick candy, candy canes and drops, is what we're kind of famous for, in addition to our chocolates, which are hand-dipped. We decided that we liked to collect candy things, so we did it on our own for a long time. We were still managing the store from California. We had the collection in our house, and then here we said we needed a permanent home for it, so we made a little museum and kept on collecting, and it's become an addiction. We're still adding items today, and in fact we're enlarging, so we've bought the building to the south, and we'll be expanding into that. The original store, we expanded to the north, and that became the demonstration area and museum, and now we're expanding to the south, and that will be more seating and more retail, and then in a year or more, we'll be building on in the back, and that will be more manufacturing.
It's just a nice family environment, working with a lot of great people and dealing with our public, just a lot of our regulars that come in. I'm a people person, so I really enjoy that part of the business.
I'm hoping the customers and the work environment's good here, and the employees are good to each other. It's like a big old family.
My favorite candy to eat that we make here is English toffee. I think it's some of the best English toffee you'll find any place.
My favorite would probably be peanut butter melt away. I like our coconut, any of our coconut items, our red hots, of course, and I really like our lemon drops too.
My candy is the peanut butter melt-aways and the red hot cinnamon creams. They're really good. And then the red hot cinnamon are good.
My favorite one I like is the dark chocolate almond bark. Mm-hmm. I like the English toffee. I like the peanut brittle. I like the espresso truffles and dark chocolate. I like the peanut clusters, the peanut butter melt-aways. I gotta hold this.
We're hoping that Schimpff's Confectionery has been an integral part of the history of Jeffersonville, and that we're giving new memories to young people and kind of bringing back old memories for people that remember coming here as well in their youth but are now in their 80s, that type of thing. So establishing new memories and continuing the old memories.